of you calling us here at the station with your condolences have also been telling us about your own personal experiences.
Some of you have lost loved ones. Some of you have even fought your own battles with depression and thoughts of suicide. Fox 4's Tess Koppelman met with one man who says he hopes others hear his message that suicide is preventable. Tess is in the newsroom tonight. Tess?
And Perry Seaton fought his own 20-year battle with depression, even tried to kill himself. He was reluctant to get help, but all that's different now, and he wants people to see that you don't have to do it alone. Just about every morning, Don Harmon made us smile. Perry Seaton especially loved this moment.
Jet streaming that impulse off the West Coast. Winds of 110.
That probably of all of them was the favorite because I could.
When he found out that Don's death was a suicide, it hit close to home for Perry.
I thought, well, how unfortunate. He just did not get the right help. He might have gotten help, but he didn't find the key to the lock, so to speak. What makes
Perry says it took some time to find that key. For him, therapy helped, but this was his key.
That's all it is. Once a day.
One little pill changed his life, but it took some trial and error.
And I remember in my particular case, what the doctor said was, trust me. You have to trust me that I will find what it is.
Perry says his depression stemmed from a rough marriage and difficulties at his job. He had tried medication, but stopped taking it.
Everyone thought everything was just great, and I walked out of the house at 2 o'clock in the afternoon with the full intention of ending.
He overdosed on pills. The doctor said it was amazing he survived, but it forced him to get help, and he discovered, just like any disease, he needed medication.
You're like a diabetic. That's a drug for life. And some people who are depressed or have that sort of problem look at it as, when I feel better, go off the drug. Bad idea. You just got to stay on it, just like you would insulin if you were a diabetic.
Play ball.
Perry hopes that if one good thing comes from Don's death, it's that people realize no one has to cope alone. There's always help if you need it.
Had he said, gee, I really think I need to go to the hospital for a while and get this thing straightened out, that might have made all the difference.
Perry also says the law protects your privacy and your job, so people shouldn't worry about what your boss or your friends might think. Just focus on getting the help you need, because it really is a life or death crisis. Tess Koppelman, Fox 4 News, working for you.